Oh guys, we're back. I'm just upgrading Allen Robinson. Those, I just accidentally forgot I wasn't recording. You see those upgrades he just got? Now, Brandon Ayuk. Nah. Route runner, my guy. What the heck? I mean, he doesn't play anyways, but. I kind of feel bad for that, but. Just didn't know my pick me my last. I think we have an all-star team, except Jamar Chase. I think I put Jamar Chase in the... Yeah. A lot, but like... You know, I said last I would be working on my defense? You know, I'm just gonna try to build up some of our team. I think. Let's get a look outside linebacker. I think that'll help our defense a lot. Be so nice. I'm going big. Like, I will get someone who's under 20. And there we go. Yeah, this is gonna be rough. Okay. I really don't care about my draft picks. And then in a second, they might bite with that. Two first round picks. Okay. Done that. I don't care though. Dude, that's actually kind of big. Now we're gonna get. I mean, he's not gonna. Crap. I don't know who this is gonna be.
Easily see how many play. Here are some recommendations to get you started.
Why are you on our team? Oh my gosh. Well, yeah, I'm cutting you. You suck. Okay, time to go smack the Bears, who I think are actually 1-0. I have no idea, I'm pretty sure they are. Are they not? They have a really good defense, speaking of defense, so. So we have to watch out for rookie Justin Fields running. He might not, though. Yes, sir, Jesse Bates, that pick. Oh, I just. Oh!
Today. From Soldier Field in Chicago.
I think Joe Mixon's good, by the way.
It's week two of the NFL on EA.
Oh, this time. Don't have the pass for 1924,
but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Chicago Bears.
And the Bears offense making their way out
now for their first drive with Justin Fields, the rookie from Ohio State, at quarterback.
Not chubby.
Okay, I thought there was something to build on in last week's game by his performance. I thought he played fairly well overall. The numbers won't knock your socks off. Two touchdown passes.
Okay, guys. So
bottom line, though,
let's see where Joey Bosa is.
Does he eliminate that one interception? Continue to take care of the ball. Non-existent.
Where is he?
Meanwhile, Fields throw there complete to Mooney, and he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
Mooney did really good.
Mooney in last week's ball game, 6 catches, 114 yards.
I like the performances he's put up throughout the year. That's the reason he's ranked number 9 in the league in receiving yards, and in a league that throws the ball around like crazy, number 9 is a good number.
And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. And Charles, we get a look here at the key inactives, and I tell you what, a big list for being this early in the season.
If there's any silver lining at all,
okay, I'm back, guys.
And now you'll play well down the stretch with them.
They're my goal.
But what you're also hoping is that the guys who have to play for them, the next
man up mentality
kicks in, and those guys take care of business.
Oh, cool. They're going to go for it. They're dumb.
Only 2 yards, and it'll be a punt on their opening possession. On fourth down, here's Sam Martin
on to kick it away. And there's the man himself, Joey Bosa, making the... This is like the only thing Ayuk does. Like, oh man, that's my fault. We got a huge return. Oh. That's a punter. He's off. And he hurt. Is he back? Yes, he is. And
right at the 30.
Look who's in. I'm going to have to get to him. I have to. Oh.
And his throw is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to drive catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the
what
bottom line
away?
Is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
He hurt? Oh, of course my mic battery's low. No! How? Ah! Why? No. Oh my gosh. No, that's bad. That's bad. Oh, no. Hiss. Meow. Shoot. That sucks. That's like 4 to... Oh, that's a lot. I think it's like 4 to 12 weeks. Or 4 to 8.
Open man is Uzama.
What is it? It's 1 or 2. 4 to 8 or 4 to 12. Still, that's 4 weeks at the minimum. And I think Lamb's injury's really low for some reason.
Flush to his right.
Boy, you can't leave Burrow like this. Whoop. Okay. He didn't get
it. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football,
there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice game.
Chase. Eagle. Blue board too. Oh my god, my mic battery's low. I legit just said that, I think, 2 seconds ago, and now I didn't plug it in.
That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk.
Alright, so I'll hit it in. I'll be back. A little bit.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. They will throw on first down with Burrow, eluding the pressure. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. Oh, he fakes a spike. Dancing to his left. Jamar Chase, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And Charles, we get a look there at the draft class for this offense. What do you make of it?
Overall, I like the balance of the guys that they selected because, to me, they got a few guys who can step in and play right away, which is exactly what you want. But they also drafted for the future as well. They've got some guys who might need a year or two on the practice squad, so then we'll find out if they can actually play. But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear.
And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Joe Mixon, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it all culminated in the touchdown run coming from Joe Mixon. Here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Now a first down throw. Fields. Over the middle. He's got Tyrell Williams. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Justin Fields, the quarterback, gets the completion there. CeeDee, what do you think the key is to stopping this talented former Buckeye?
Pressure, pressure, pressure. Rookie quarterbacks have to survive the initiation of the pressure of the NFL. Now, his athleticism can scare you a little bit because if he evades it, he can go a long way. But in the beginning, you want his eyes to go to the rush, not downfield. So bring those extra guys and see if he can handle it.
On first and 10, here's Fields. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second down, Montgomery. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. David Montgomery, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week 2 now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. On the return, Williams. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now Burrow. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. Here's 2nd and 10. From the shotgun, it's Burrow, escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Well, he's got to have that wrong, doesn't he? They declined there.
There's no doubt about it. Sorry to step on you there, partner, but let's go ahead and run this one together, right? Incomplete pass. Yeah, they call pass interference, and somehow you're going to decline that
penalty? I'm so confused. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. Again, it's Burrow. Flushed out right. And he'll go right back to Chase. That's caught again. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. There's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. The red zone now. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Mixon. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Joe Mixon with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Bengals have taken the lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Here's Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It's a pretty nice throw right there from the rookie. And this, of course, is game number 2 of his NFL career. His guys did not get the win, Charles, in the opener. But what did you see from him last week?
Well, I think all things considered, he played pretty well, and I don't think I'd pin the loss on him. But there's no question, this is a learning process, and that was step 1. And he's hoping on the road to glory.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. DJ Reader, able to get him for a loss of about 3. Throwing on third down, Fields. And Graham's got it over the middle. And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. Here's Sam Martin now as he'll kick it away for the second time. This will be fielded at the 17. So a change of possession here on the punt. The Bengals drive about to get going. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. Good, strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Meanwhile, Burrow's throw taken in here by Chase. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Got the defense on their heels. 2 first downs in a row and now a pickup of 8. Ahead of the chains now, 2nd and 2.
I am back in. Let's go. Okay, we're doing pretty good.
Burrow looking to pass. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll find Chase on the right side.
Didn't mean to lob that one up, but.
And he is out of bounds, someone's hurt. But not before he's inside the 30.
Ooh. I mean, I used kind of like.
On first down, escaping the pressure right.
Who's this?
This is
Allen Robinson.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Like, I didn't mean to really do that. Like, that.
Inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts.
Save my Chrome with 22 seconds to go.
Wow. Here in half number 1. To throw on 2nd and 6. Burrow, buying time.
I threw it. Now we have a little more room.
Second of their timeouts. As they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number 1.
I mean, we don't really need much room.
With a 3rd and long after that sack we just saw.
She shoot. No, too late.
He'll look to throw. Got a man open, it's Chase.
Oh man, you gotta hold the block. Allen Robinson. He's long.
With 9 seconds to go in this first half of play.
He can score.
Fourth and goal, and down by a touchdown. The offense stays on the field.
Out, but if Jamar Chase doesn't get open, then this route's just toast. It's just
fourth down. Here's Joe Burrow. And it's caught. They didn't get the touchdown, but he did.
Come on. No.
Get the first down as he's tackled at the
swear he was in.
So we have reached halftime with a touchdown.
You want the he was
ready? No problem. In. Let's do it. The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead.
He caught it in the end.
To begin quarter number three.
Oh, Williams, no, I didn't mean to catch it.
Hold it. With a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call.
18. What was that?
That holding call set him up with not great field position.
With that field position after the return wasn't terrific, it's not a great starting field position as well.
Jamar Chase or Allen, obviously.
And they go play action now. Burrow.
Jamar.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. He's got a man.
Oh, he's going.
And he finally is out of bounds, but he's down inside the 20-yard line.
They're only really, really fast.
Big play there for Cincinnati. A real field flipper there.
Do I go ahead and go get Debo Samuel?
And that'll be incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him,
I'm gonna go get myself Debo Samuel. That's gonna be really hard to do without a first round or second round or pick, but we got it.
Another shot for Chase. He's got it this time.
We'll give him my uke.
They get seven out of that. So
a second and a
third.
And three. That's the best.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense. Find the holes where guys are available.
Yeah, it's gonna be great
before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. They'll roll him out.
Y'all
right.
Fools, my friend.
And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown.
I don't know if we get rid of him now.
There to make the grab. And
the oh, that's Allen Robinson. Okay, never mind. Yeah, we can get rid of Brandon
right
Ayuk.
Down the field to extend their lead. A nice
yeah,
throw there
that,
by the second year quarterback.
Okay.
And I don't
that's
believe that's the kind of play you would have made
we're
as a rookie. Because
spend
usually your rookie season is a continuation
Samuel.
Of your college days. A lot of one
third.
Read, and if you don't
it's
have
not
it,
gonna work.
Go.
A second and
now
a third.
In the
and
a
I
more.
I mean
reading the field.
They might want
second,
wide receivers actually.
And
if we give them
a
81 yeah, that's what it is. 81 wide overall wide receiver. You know, might work a little bit because it's an 80 overall. That's at least going to be a quarter, a second round pick. What do we give for? I think we gave a oh, we gave a second for them. Oh, shoot. Nah, come on, man. Uh-oh, something injured.
Now we're going to get a stoppage.
So it was Lamb actually injured? So was Lamb the one who was injured or was it the kicker? It was like their kicker, but probably was Lamb, I guess. Yes. I can use her. Nope. He should not have been able to do that. Well, why is Josie Bosa not playing Josie? I'm calling him Josie Bosa until he gets a sack.
Back to throw. Fields. He'll get this underneath to Montgomery.
Who's better,
the
Watts or Bosa?
I
think Watts.
Short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. They do get 12, but they'll be marked short.
Bosa's just, nah.
Here's Sam Martin now.
Get him on staff. They're not, like, feared as the Watts. When you watch a team play the Steelers, they will not
They'll get 9 yards on the return there following a punt of 42. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Well, heavens. I'm saying it as I know I'm going to be able to get rid of IU and get Debo. We get Debo worse that our team has everything. He didn't go up for that. That was a few wide open.
I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant.
Because then we would have, who would be sitting out there? Defense ended up winning the battle. Jamar Chase. Actually, no, it would be,
And he's going to be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bengals 38.
Yeah, let's think about that one. Because how much playing time has IU had? None. He had one reception. And now he has five. But I don't see Debo. Actually, Debo would. I mean, Jamar Chase would get a lot of playing time because of the fact that Lamb's going to be injured. Probably, my guess is going to be 12 weeks. He's going to be out for a while. Oh, that's a pick six. Bro, why is this guy so slow that a lineman? Oh, that's sad. I actually had them. I know he's taking the angle and stuff, but. Yeah, I mean, we might do that. Because. But we play 500 snaps with Jamar Chase.
And the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on
this
level.
That's what sucks.
So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
Who's Allen Robinson's a level overall, which won't happen. Here to IU. And I don't think. Let's just keep IU. I just want a really fast wide receiver. We don't really have that. I mean, we do. But he's out. I think he's faster than you here. I have no idea. Oh, God. I thought it was going to the ball way right as I was. Got the snap.
Second down and goal. Whoop, Burrow. Whoop, whoop. And a quick throw here, that's complete.
You mean? I'm challenging that. Yes, there is ball placement.
Final play of this third quarter.
I swear, if I see.
So he'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this is the NFL.
Bruh, chill, my friend. Sports.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
Oh, that's holding. That's holding. He used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. Where is roughing the passer?
Is there only one of the game? Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers.
Well, I did not rough the passer. Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. Bruh. What is that?
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10.
Roughing the passer, flopper.
Here, now it's Fields.
Thank you. Oh, come on.
But it's incomplete.
So much for the best laid
plans. Bro, it says Joey Bosa on the field.
That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for them to get in there. It sails incomplete.
On second and 10.
Keep blowing up, Jimmy.
Graham's got it. Complete.
No, Jimmy Graham.
5 yards. Must now not it's third and five.
Thank you, Wolf.
Now Fields.
Why? Is that so?
And Fields gonna have the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy, make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play, a perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
On first down, Fields. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. They have to like the position that they are in. Fourth quarter, two-score lead, and now the ball back after the INT.
Guess we got a pickup. Good.
First down. Here's Burrow. Forced out to his left. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
That's a flop.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
Play action. It's Burrow.
Uzma.
Wide open receiver complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up?
Yeah, how about that game?
It, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta,
I feel bad for Atlanta.
Apologies.
I'm surprised they even did that good.
Flushed out right.
Nothing to pass to. Jamar Chase S is
this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Steps away to his left. He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. Allen Robinson. Two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Bengals are on their way to a 2-0 start. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21.
Easy done. I told you this game too easy. No.
So after the made field goal, here's
the fans are uncoordinated. Anybody else hear that? Seriously,
the
fans are even uncoordinated. Starting field position.
Here comes Justin Fields and the rest of the Bears offense. And that interception that ended their previous drive likely also ended any shot they had at victory.
Yep,
yeah,
it's over.
Back from here, no doubt
21
about that
points,
one,
3 touchdowns on our semi-good defense.
And he can't find
cut it
receiver,
out.
And he's brought down. Trey Hendrickson, he's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss. Now following the sack, they'll come up here on a second down and 12. Fields.
Bruh, get your man. That wasn't even my user.
Taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that
minimum
last completion.
Though, 4 weeks?
Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
On first down, it's Fields. This one swung out to Montgomery. And he's got this down to the 35. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Fields on first down.
Holy.
That's complete to Mooney. Touchdown, Chicago.
24 seconds.
Darnell Mooney, 35 yards.
Ooh.
And the Bears have got it back to a two-score
And that's the personnel, Darnell Mooney. He's a deep threat. Allen Robinson's not.
Santos able to tack on the extra point, and the lead will be cut down to 14. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this is going to be snuffed out.
You can't hit it right. Wow, Texans gonna go next. Wow. Not doing that bad. I mean, not doing that bad. That's not
that onside kick. They didn't get him.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe
no.
Intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need.
No, it's not.
Picked off by Tashaun Gibson. And the Bears are right back in this football game. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Here comes Justin Fields and the rest of the Bears offense. And those numbers, they kind of tell the story of his game so far. Started off not so hot, now he's really heated up.
And remember, he signed up for duty as the guy who leads the team, right?
Get out of here.
So when things go rocky early, he can't just exit out and ask someone else to pick things up. He's got to do it himself, and that's what he's done
Bye-bye.
Here in this game.
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Fields going to hurry his guys to the line.
Again.
Another try after the
Bro.
First down sack. Fields. Pass the 20.
Deal.
And he takes this one into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hand steam ready.
No doubt about it.
No.
Santos with the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So with an even 30 seconds to
Kay.
Go, everything will come down to this onside kick.
Let's not screw this up.
And this is going to be recovered by the hand team. And that should just about put a camper on this one. Now, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics
and our
into the game, and
covered.
Someone has said here that the data says it.
No,
we didn't
really
an
ball.
Kick, 80% of
one
the
more
time,
pass, one more pass.
The team expecting
one
it,
more
they
pass.
Do actually
then
recover the
run.
Ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type
there
of
you
number.
Go.
I like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Mixon with a first down carry.
Wow.
He's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Some power, my rook.
They'll stay on the ground.
Not
Mixon
as good
again.
As compared to his first one.
And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game.
32 passing plays.
On first down. Mixon.
Bro.
He stopped immediately there. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left.
Come on. Oh, man.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Is that a one just four verticals? Yeah, okay. We'll score the sample, I guess. Here. Don't wanna, but we can.
Steps away.
No shot.
And the Bengals are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals.
You know,
and we talked so much about the turnover
battle
determining who wins and who loses.
Won.
This game, no exception. They didn't turn the ball over at all, and they go on to victory.
They look like a smooth operation in this one, didn't they? Because you look at every facet of the game, they handled their business. Offense took care of the football, converted it into points. Defense took the ball away, gave it back to the offense. Special teams.
Oh,
right,
we're doing
some. That's the type
really
of game a coach is gonna really
surprise
love.
You guys will be like, you guys enjoyed that.